And when we say Q, Q means heat, and W equals work. Now, when it comes to these two terms, they can either be positive or negative based on certain keywords that your professors like to use. So we're going to say that Q, it can be positive when we say that the system gains, takes in, or absorbs heat or energy from the surroundings. We say that Q can be negative when we say the system loses, evolves, gives off, or releases heat or energy to the surroundings. So remember, if the system is absorbing energy, why is it doing that? It's because the surroundings are giving it to it. If the system is losing energy, where is it going? It's going to our surroundings. Now for work, we're going to say that work can also be positive or negative. We're going to say when work is done on the system by the surroundings, then work will be positive. The key word we're going to see here is volume compresses. So basically, volume gets smaller. If the volume is getting smaller, that means that the surroundings are doing work on our system. Work could be negative if we say that when work done by system on the surroundings. Keyword here, volume expands. The volume increases. So if you see the volume increasing, that's because our system is doing that. It's doing the work. And therefore, work would be negative. So what you need to remember is, what's the equation for the internal energy of the system? And will my work and heat be positive or negative based on certain keywords that the professor will ask?